You're watching Newsround. It's Thursday, the 22nd of September. Lots to get through today, including... I'm only human after all. I'm only human. Can Rag & Bone Man make music lessons more interesting and fun? And some amazing new pictures of Neptune's rings. First up, UK's new Prime Minister Liz Truss has called on countries around the world to do more to support Ukraine in its fight against Russia. It's now been almost 7 months since Russia invaded Ukraine, and earlier this week, the UK government pledged to give an extra £2 billion to help Ukraine in its fight back against its much larger neighbour. This week, world leaders have been meeting at the UN General Assembly in New York to discuss the big issues affecting countries across the globe, and Liz Truss used her speech to show her praise for Ukraine for their efforts in the war so far.
The Ukrainians aren't just defending their own country. They're defending our values and the security of the whole world. That's why we must act.
Well, Russia has said it will call up 300,000 extra troops to join the fight against Ukraine, but this has led to protests in the country as many people are unhappy with President Putin's actions. The UK government has said this latest move is evidence that Russia's strategy and invasion of Ukraine is failing. Well, you can find out more about what's been happening in the war with Ukraine and Russia over on our website. While you're there, why not check out some other stories too, including why Minecraft are teaming up with the team from Frozen Planet to create 5 new Frozen worlds. Find out more about 2 schools that are in the running for the world's best school competition. And do you know your beach from your horse chestnut? It's the start of autumn, so why not take our special autumn leaves competition quiz? Next up, the music that you stream and download help you to pick up an instrument. I've been finding out how a new online tool, including tracks from Beyoncé and Queen, is being launched to help children enjoy and try and understand music lessons in schools. Take a look. Sounds you're probably used to hearing in your school music lessons. But how about this? Songs like Human by Rag & Bone Man are part of a plan to breathe new life into music lessons across the UK. It's called Classroom 200 and it's a free online portal for teachers. It features hundreds of tracks to make music lessons a bit more interesting and help connect kids to music through songs they already know. So does it work?
Probably a bit, because like I've heard more of those songs than the songs I'm listening to now in music lessons, so it may have been a bit easier or a bit more fun.
If we had bigger songs, we could play along with them, like Rag & Bone Man. I'm only human after all.
When it comes to playing an instrument, the latest research suggests only 47% of 16 to 17-year-olds play one. And that's compared to 64% of 8 to 10-year-olds. So it's quite clear, isn't it, that there is a problem here with music lessons. Why are so many people, young people, growing up and then being turned off by playing an instrument and participating in music lessons? Is it because of the kind of music on offer? Is it too classical? Maybe a little bit too old-fashioned?
Well, I think it would be more interesting for sort of people who aren't really into music, so they would enjoy their music lessons more.
The classics haven't been binned entirely. There are still some on offer. And although most of the songs on here are new, some were released around 20 years ago, so you may not have heard them before. There are also themes from TV shows and films like Doctor Who and the Pirates of the Caribbean. OK, still to come on the programme this morning. Good news for green sea turtles in Cyprus. And we asked the experts if we'll ever know what colour dinosaurs were in this week's Big Question. Next, check out this incredible picture of the icy planet Neptune. It was taken by NASA's James Webb Telescope and is the clearest picture of the planet captured in 30 years. It shows off the planet's rings and dust bands in incredible detail, as well as some of the moons that orbit the planet. Amazing stuff. Next up, it's time for another of your big questions. And this week, Paul from Otley in England asks, will we ever know the true colour of dinosaurs? Well, let's find out.
Yes, a lot of the pictures that you're going to see of dinosaurs will appear as dull greens, greys and browns. It's quite common. Early pictures of dinosaurs especially. You see, way back when dinosaurs were starting to be discovered and illustrations, paleo art was being drawn of them, the inspiration that most of them took was from modern-day reptiles. Dinosaurs are reptiles. And a lot of reptiles are kind of duller colours. So it makes sense to copy and follow suit with what living animals look like today. But nowadays, we know that there's a much stronger link between dinosaurs and birds. In fact, birds are avian dinosaurs. Yeah, they didn't really go extinct. So looking at bird colours and thinking about dinosaurs, well, there's a lot of very colourful birds out there, aren't there? And one of the things that we've been able to find in some of our fossils are what we call melanosomes. A good example of this is a dinosaur known as Cynoceropteryx. I've got a cast of it here. Now, melanosomes are really tiny, tiny structures, but they can tell you what colour things were. Modern-day birds have melanosomes, so do dinosaurs. And so by looking at these structures, we can figure out what colour they might have been. So Cynoceropteryx here is a really good example because we can tell you what colour it is. It had a reddish auburn kind of colour, a bit like a fox, and a stripy tail, a bit like a raccoon. Amazing, isn't it? We've got all of that from rock.
That is amazing. Thank you so much, Tom, for answering that question. Finally, I wanted to show you these awesome pictures that have come into the Newsround office this morning. Look at this beautiful green turtle, one of the biggest sea turtles on the planet. Divers managed to get up close to this one off the coast of Cyprus in the Mediterranean Sea. Now, sea turtle populations have declined throughout the world, but the creatures and their eggs are now protected by laws in Cyprus. And new research suggests the number of sea turtles taken illegally has dropped. That is some good news to end on today, isn't it? Thank you for joining us this morning. Have an amazing day at school. Hayley will be back with your next news round tomorrow morning. I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.